Dear participants, this is problem statement number 5 of track 2. This problem statement aims at developing simple, interpretable, and easily transferable regression-based QSPR models for CACO2 cell permeability. Only 2D descriptors should be used to avoid the problems of conformational analysis, energy minimization, alignment, etc. associated with 3D QSR problems. The descriptors used should have definite physicochemical meaning, providing appropriate mechanistic interpretation. The models should be developed as per the OECD guidelines. QSPR or quantitative structure property relationship is basically a ligand-based approach, which we start from appropriate molecular structure representation from which a set of descriptors can be generated, which can then be subjected to feature selection tools to extract important features, and then an appropriate regression-based algorithm can be used to develop the model, which can then be validated using different metrics and interpreted for design of new compounds. Here the property value which we are going to use should be in the log scale. The data set should be divided into a training and a test set. The training set should be used for model development and the test set should be used for the validation purpose using different metrics with consideration of applicability domain. And finally, the model should be interpreted. According to OECD Principle 1, the endpoint should be defined. According to Principle 2, there should be an unambiguous algorithm. According to OECD Principle 4, there should be appropriate measures of goodness of fit and predictability of the model. According to OECD Principle 3, there should be a check for applicability domain, and according to OECD Principle 5, the model should have a mechanistic interpretation. The data set given should be divided into training and test set. In addition, the training set can be further stratified into k number of calibration sets and k variation sets from which k models can be developed, and their quality of predictions can be tested for the corresponding validation sets, and from that the best model can be chosen based on the performance on the validation sets. One can also go for consensus predictions, which are more reliable than predictions from individual models. QSPR or quantitative structure property relationship is basically a ligand based approach, which we start from appropriate molecular structure representation from which a set of descriptors can be generated, which can then be subjected to. One can also innovate for new methods of feature selection, new methods of selection of appropriate training set compounds, and new methods of defining applicability domain. Descriptors can be computed using different tools like alpha descriptor, Dragon, Paddle Descriptor, and so on. The models can be generated from DTCLab tools or some statistical package like Statistica. The outcome of the analysis should be provided in the supply 3 input forms to provide with the model quality and the details of descriptors used, along with the calculated and predicted values of the training and tested compounds and AD information, the predicted values of the blinded compounds, and a list of top ranked 100 compounds from the CAS antiviral database with predicted activity and AD information. Some of the references are suggested. All the best.